Hi, my name is Nestor, and on today's lesson, we will talk about some phrasal verbs that we normally use with the verb start and the verb finish. Let's get started. So we have a couple of phrasal verbs right here. We have finish with, finish off. We will see the difference between the two of them, as well as we will see the difference with start back, start up, and start on. And last but not least, we will finish by explaining the difference between end in and end up. We see the verbs right now. Finish with these people right here, Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt. It's very well known that she finished with him because she has been dealing with different kind of situation with her personal health, and she went through different treatments. So at the end, she just finished with Brad Pitt. Anyway, they got together, but a couple of years after a really beautiful relationship, I will say, they just broke up. We got right here the definition finish with, which is basically to end a romantic relationship with someone. And we got another example right here for you to read it, so you have a better understanding when to use finish with. All right, so let's move on to the next phrasal verb, which is finish off. I guess that everybody loves pizza. I personally prefer pepperoni pizza. I guess it's the best pizza in the world. But, you know, when we buy the box of pizza, we might eat, I don't know, from 1 to 3 slices per person as an average. I personally eat like 4 slices. I know that it could be a lot, but that's the thing, right? The thing is, I love pizza, especially pepperoni. I also like vegetarian pizza, but you know, I rather prefer pepperoni pizza. So when we have the last slice of pizza, or maybe 2 slices of pizza, or maybe 3, we say when the box is almost empty and there are a couple of pizza left, we might say that don't throw it away, let me finish off with my pizza, which means that you will need to finish the whole slice of pizza before you just threw it away. We got the definition right there in order for you to have a better understanding. And another sentence, and the sentence says, Kelly finished off his coffee. Now, let's move on to the second part of the phrasal verse. We have start back, start up, and start on. So let's get ready. Okay, I guess that everybody have seen this movie, We Have to Go Back. Let's imagine that you're going from one place to another place, especially if you're in Nicaragua. Let's say that you're going from Managua to Granada, or from Managua to Matagalpa, or from Managua to León. And if you go to Granada, maybe you want to go to the Isletas. And if you go to Matagalpa, maybe you want to go to Selva Negra. If you go to León, maybe you go to Poneloya. At the end of having a really good time with anybody that you go with, it's time to come back, right? Home, to the place where you originally are. So we will say that we use start back, which means that we need to return back where we belong to. That will be start back. A startup have to do with companies, have to do with entrepreneurship. For example, I just started up, right, with a company in 2009. The company was selling cell phones. It was a really good experience, but definitely I rather prefer to change of industry. And now, you know, I've been teaching English since then. So most likely we will use startup for business, right? So you got the idea of the business, then you get the people or the resources, and then The idea becomes a startup, and after a startup becomes an enterprise or company. Then we have start on. Start on, it's basically when you move on quickly or when you just start with something almost immediately or when you deal with something right away, right? So for example, I normally start on my day with some prayers. Then I might take a shower, get dressed, and start on working right away. So we get one more time the definition right here and some examples that you can have a better understanding or how to use start on. And definitely we have and, end, and end up. It's very interesting how to use ending. Ending has to do with results. No matter what you do, the progress at the end, there is a result, right? For example, let's say that if you go to the gym and you start doing some cardio, at the end, the result is that you're gonna be losing some weights, right? Another example could be, let's say that you're having a discussion with your girlfriend or boyfriend and suddenly one of them just finished crying. So that was the result of the conversation. One of the characters or one of the persons involved in the argument started to cry or end in crying, right? That is how we use end in. Then we have end up. This is very interesting how these people met each other. Anyway, they went to a blind date and I guess that he had some ideas about what she was doing as an actress. She was working in a suit series, I guess. But well, after the blind date, he invited her to go to Africa, I guess, to see some animals or something like that. He ended up marrying her. Well, I guess just lucky. One more time, we got the definition and we got another example in order for you to have your idea. To sum up, we have finish with versus finish off. Finish with has to do with relationship. For example, I remember when I was in high school, life girlfriend had in the past, they finished with me. Why? Because different reasons, right? Nobody is perfect. Anyway, finish off, you know, it has to do with food or drinks. Imagine that you're drinking a glass of Coca-Cola or a glass of wine or a glass of water, whatever you're drinking, whatever you're eating, and there's something still left that you want to continue eating until it's off or it's finished, right? That is when we use finish off. Starbucks. Remember, if you go to Granada, you go to Isletas, you enjoy, you have a really good time there, then eventually it's you will find the time to come back home so that it will be a start back. A startup has to do with business. If you have an idea and after the idea you get the resources or the people, then it becomes a startup. Start on, it's when you have different kind of activities or tasks that you need to start working on them, right? So that is when you use start on. And in and end up. And in, talking with somebody and you are expecting some results. And finally we have end up. Let me share something really personal. I from Leon and I decided to come to Managua to do some courses on finance, because I was studying economics back on those days. But I end up having girlfriend and getting married and not having kids, which is a really good thing. Okay, and last but not least, we also have stop out and stop off. Basically, this is the difference. If we talk about stop out, imagine that you enroll yourself into a course at the university, it doesn't matter what kind of course, and let's say that the length of the course, it might take between 3 to 4 years, but after a couple of time, let's say 6 months or a year, you decided not to continue with the course, you will say that you will do a stop out, which just mean that you will pause the course for a moment because you need to do something else. And if we talk about stop off, let's say that you are going to do a long trip, right? You need to go from Managua to León. So on the way going to León, there are some kind of huts where you can buy some quesillo. You stop off at Nagarote and then you buy some quesillo and having a really good time eating it. Okay, now since you already have all that information about phrasal verb with start and finish, it's time for you to answer the following questions. Keep in mind that the main idea on these following questions is that you record yourself in a video between 45 seconds to a minute. And what you need to do is to pick one of these questions and send us an audio so we can listen to it and give you proper feedback about it. Thank you very much for watching. This is Nestor from Nicalingue, and I see you in class. Take care.